From this is a 6 month old company, mm-hmm. and you're kind of very, very new in the industry.
Mm-hmm.
My question would be, how did you come up with the name?
Well, Beanie Boshi. Well, first, it's a beanie hat.
Beanie hat.
So we kind of tweaked the name to make it sound a little Japanese sounding, mm-hmm. you know. Well, I'm not faulting the kids today, but they're into K-pop and J-pop. if they once they hear about it, Beanie Boshi, it sounds Japanese.
Right. And Japanese is basically what about this thing.
But well, it's Filipino made, and proud to be Filipino made.
Yeah, you don't do some imported stuff here. You don't use imported materials.
No. These are all local materials.
Local materials. That means that you are helping the economy.
Yeah. Hooray.
You're right. Definitely. Your course in college.
Well, I took up BS Ed. Actually, I took up. I'm a BS Ed, history major.
History major.
Yeah.
How is that helping you now? How is that helping
but,
you?
But since I belong to a family of artists, well, it.
Oh, wait a minute. No. Whose idea was that?
Which one?
For you to take the history thing.
Well, I'm a history wonk actually. Okay. I like reading history stuff.
So why not pursue it and then leave the business?
Well, I can do both.
You can do both.
To be honest, yeah.
Right.
It helps me a lot as an artist and as a writer.
Right. Uh-oh. Since wala dito yung sister mo.
She has classes.
Yeah, she has her class in the UP Diliman.
Yeah, UP Diliman.
Okay. In UP Diliman. She's taking
fine arts.
Fine arts. Uh-oh. Okay, let's talk about her. She's a type of girl, mm-hmm. that is what, active in extracurricular activities or very focused on the academics?
Well, one thing I can say about my sister, she's very well-rounded. Despite being very artistic, I'm not gonna rip people who are very artistic, pero sometimes people who tend to be artistic, they tend to be so aloof, you know?
Yeah, and so weird, very unhuman.
But with my sister, well, she's quite well-rounded, and she's well in tune to what is what's hot in the market right now.
Right.
She does her research at a very young age.
Right. So starting this idea as a project, mm-hmm. in school, mm-hmm. was she the one who said let's do it?
Yeah. Upon the project
support
of my
me.
Parents. Yeah.
Give me.
Can you think of something new? My sister, kasi, she's quite a fashionista, fashionista type.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'll do a beanie hat. Mm-hmm. I just wanna see. I'll probably sell around 10 pieces in this bazaar.
Mm, right.
It sold in a matter of minutes. Everybody was buying these.
Right.
At first, they thought probably it was maybe it's parang one shot pony. And they tried it in other bazaars, and that they participated.
Right.
Until, well, my parents saw the potential of it.
Right, and they focused all the resources.
Focused all the resources. My parents and the rest of the family, they do the production. My sister, she does the designs.
Mm-hmm. And you do the marketing?
I did the marketing. I used to do it in the corporate world.
Really?
But I have to support my sibling.
Right. Definitely. Mm-hmm. So this is not the typical business model that you will need a very intensive capitalization.
Not really.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And really. This is not a business where you should be thinking of really great ideas.
This is just
exercising your creativity.
You just have to have boundless imagination.
Mm-hmm.
Kumbaga sa ano, yan ang pahuna mo, boundless imagination.
And your sister, the name is?
Angela.
Angela is doing this, a lot of this.
Yeah, she does. She doodles a lot. You won't see her without her sketchpad. At the same time, she does her research in the internet,
mm-hmm.
seeing what are the latest fads.
Kanina siya nagmana?
Both parents. Both parents.
So, and you are...
And I have cousins who also are artists who are very good illustrators.
Right.
Well, some are musicians. One is even a guitarist in a popular band. I'm allowed to mention.
Actually, what's the name of the band?
The guitarist of the band, Kwan.
Kwan!
Jorel's my cousin.
Okay.
Shout out to Jorel.
Let's say
he's in
hi.
Berkeley right now, he's right. studying. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Hi there. Hi. Hello. How
it's
are
Christmas.
You? Merry Christmas.
Mind sending something.
Yeah, good. So, this one is helping the. How many employees do you have?
We're limited to. Right now, depends on the demand. Sometimes, if we have a very big demand, at times we employ even our neighbors. Mm-hmm. Even our neighbors.
So you say, okay, neighbor, there is a production
neighbor,
here.
Instead
here.
Of gossiping, help us out.
Instead of talking just around, go here and then fix it. This is basically a family business. Right?
Family business, and at times we do our best to, well, give opportunities to others. Then.
All right. Have you ever worked in the corporate world? Me?
Well, for the longest time, I was a copywriter. I used to be a TV writer too.
All right.
That was my first gig, TV writer, and for almost 5 years, I was a graphic artist too. So
this is the typical 8-to-5, 9-to-6 job.
Which one? This.
The corporate thing, right?
Yeah, the typical. Yeah.
Right. Now, what's the difference between working for someone and working within your family business?
Well, that's how. When you're working for someone, of course, it's still the same. Eh? You're working for someone. You're working for yourself. Yeah, you still have to give it your best. Because at the end of the day, it's still accomplishment that matters.
Right.
So, but in this case, of course, this is ours. Mm-hmm. But, we could really come up with things na well less discussions.
Right.
Know?
Right.
At the same time, you still have to do your research. Eh?
Right, right. Lesser politics and all, something like that.
I didn't say that. No, kind of.
When we work in corporations, basically there are that. I mean, you cannot decide on your own. People say this and that.
There are long debates.
Right, right.
Debates are healthy, but at times, it kind of stalls things.
You know? Right. Stalls things. Definitely. When you finally registered the business, what was the main motivation?
Well, the main motivation was, well, for Beanie Boshi really to be the top beanie hat producing brand out there. Well, right. there are other brands out there, but the thing is,
I haven't heard of any.
Oh, there
any
are,
brand.
But the thing with us with Beanie Boshi, because we're flexible in terms of designs. Since this is locally made, it's easy for us to know what is hot in the market, you know, what will sell, and it's easy for us to, let's say, for example, we need to do 100 yellow colored theme hats. We can do that, you know, in a short time.
Right.
Less approvals, you know.
Less approvals. Mm-hmm. So mas mabilis yung nagagawa.
Mas mabilis o kumbaga. Mas madali kami mag-react sa market kung ano yung mas uso.
Right, but this is a very easy business to put up. Mm-hmm. I mean, just, you know, for someone to come up with this kind of business, very easy.
Well, to be honest, we were even surprised that it really caught on real fast.
So my question is, can anybody out there just put up almost the same business, produce almost the same creativity and quality, and they can compete with you?
Well, let's put it this way. All you have to have is determination. Eh? Mm-hmm. You have to have vision. You have to have the heart to pursue what you really want.
Right.
Otherwise, it will be really mundane. Eh? It will have a quick death. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Right.
But if you have the passion to do it, you will really give it your all. That will be the driving force
right.
behind it.
Are you not afraid that determined passionate individuals, creative individuals out there will just try to do this too?
Well, you can't
cannot prevent them.
You can't prevent that. We live in a democracy.
Stop doing this business. This is ours.
It's a democracy. And of course, for us that's okay because competition is healthy. Honestly, it will push all the players to give it their all.
Okay, so maybe we can invite them to compete with you.
Yeah, go ahead. By all means.
By all means. So,